first I thought, well, I need to tell people, like, you need to eat vegetables and you need to do all the things Sandra just said. You need to exercise and you need to focus on these healthy behaviors. But turns out most people can't do that. Like, that's really hard. And so as I spoke with people, I started hearing what the real problems are with trying to get healthy. So to let me know if any of these sound familiar. Who's too busy to work to do this stuff, right? Like, or I would hear things like, it's too expensive. Fresh foods and vegetables are way too expensive. I'm just too tired. I can't do it. I hate vegetables. I can't eat healthy. Self-talk, I don't have the willpower. I don't have the discipline. It can't be done. Or social reasons, everybody else does it. I can't change. Or my family won't do it, the biggest one of all. So, but at the end of the day, there are people who are more busy than you, have less time than you, have less money than you, and can still eat healthy and do these healthy behaviors. So really, at the end of the day, it's an issue of psychology, not of nutrition. And so what's important then is focusing on your brain, because as Sandra explained, you need to get these behaviors down. You know, if you stop thinking about the diet, stop thinking about the number on the scale, at the end of the day, you just need to do the things that make you healthy. Some people will lose weight. You can probably get to the bottom of your defended range, or at least, you know, near there. You can lose a few pounds. I lost weight. You lost weight too, right, when you started doing it? You do lose weight. You might not lose 150 pounds, but you will feel so much better, and you will look better. You will be healthier. And that is should become the goal. But for one of the reasons the diets fail, you can't rely on willpower, right? You can't rely on willpower to do these things. It's too hard because a diet, like she said, is 24 hours a day. So instead, I propose we focus on habits. And today I'm going to describe to you how to do that. So the habits are the diet antidote. So for starters, 90% of the food choices you already make are habit-based. The cool thing about habits is once they're formed, they happen automatically. You don't have to think about them. That's what a habit is. And they don't require willpower once they're formed. Habits are lasting. Good habits are just as hard to break as bad ones. When I can't go to the gym for several days in a row, I go absolutely crazy. And you think that fitness people are just a different breed, but that's not true. Once you start to really find a physical activity you love, it's addicting. You really want to keep doing it, not because you have to and not because you want to lose weight. And habits are brilliant because they evoke the 80-20 principle, which means that if you're doing the right thing most of the time, what you do occasionally doesn't matter so much. So if it's your birthday, if it's your anniversary, you can go have a glass of champagne and a slice of cake, and you don't have to feel bad about it. So, quick description of how habits work. So, what distinguishes a habit from a regular, any other action that you take, any other behavior, is that it's got three components. One is the cue or trigger, which is the thing that initiates the action. Then you have the action that follows. And then there's always a reward at the end. And the reward is the special part, because what it does is it tells your brain, keep doing that. It reinforces that cue. And so the reward and the cue are paired, and what they do is they initiate the action. Does that make sense? So that reinforcement is what's very powerful in the habit loop. And you can read all about this. This is a wonderful book called The Power of Habit by Charles Duhigg, and he describes the golden rule of habit change, which is pairing the same trigger with the same reward and just scripting a new action in the middle. So rather than trying to use willpower, you reshape your habits and then healthiness will follow. And this typically takes, I mean, there's a lot of rumors out there about how long it takes to form a new habit. It really depends on the habit and on you, but typically 2 weeks to 6 months is your typical range for forming new habits.